Welcome to the advanced level July, August, September curriculum. If you are just getting into the advanced, this is your first quarter in advanced class, congratulations on your promotion. We're going to be jump right on in to the kicking, because that's one of the newest things in this one. Some new things you get to work on, a lot of fun, a bit of a challenge for a lot of people. We're not going to go into all the basic or beginner and intermediate kicking and hand techniques, because that's what that was for. You should be getting fairly good at those. All the blow blocks, high blocks, inside out, outside in, front kick, round kick, side kick, those things. We're going to move right on into the skip side hook kick, backspin hook kick. We have the bag hanging back here for a jump backspin, inside out, a jump back side kick, and a jump back kick. Just to test out your athletic ability and your physical skills. Some people do real well at it, some people just do okay, it's fine. It's a matter of whether you learn the technique or not. So what we're going to do first off is the skip side hook kick. I think we have enough, let me get that target and I'll hold it for you, we have enough room in front of the bag. Mr. Martinez is going to demonstrate the skip side hook kick. You can back up a little bit more if you need to, sir. All right, he's going to come through, he's going to hit the target here with his heel. Flexibility is great on this thing. If you hit the higher the kick, the better, the cooler it looks, cooler. That doesn't mean anything, because you can use a hook kick on the legs, knees, thighs, things like that. Come ahead, sir, skip side hook kick. He skips in, almost like a side kick, shoots the leg out over here in a locked position, bends the knee back, hits the target through. Go ahead again. All right, one more time, sir, and we'll do it from a different angle. Skip side hook kick. All right, he's striking with the heel. That's good. That's how you break pieces of wood with it. Now, if you're just trying to do it during sparring class, he's going to demonstrate just slapping. You can probably back up a little bit more. I'm probably in a good range here. Slapping it with the bottom of his foot. Go ahead. When you slap it with your toes pointed toward your target, if you're a good kicker and you hit somebody in the head, you're just slapping them like an open hand instead of like hitting them with a fist. If you hit them with a fist, that's like your heel hitting them. It hits a lot harder. Now you can go ahead and strike it with your heel. Alright, that was a skip side. Idan Naksechagi. Idan Naksechagi. Skip side hook kick. Now we're going to do a back spinning hook kick. Naksechagi is a hook kick. Dwi Naksechagi is a back spinning hook kick. You can move up a little bit if you're concerned about that bag. Back spinning hook type of kick. Go ahead and do it again. He locks his leg out. It's almost like doing a misfired side kick. He's still turning. Bends the knee back. Sets his foot back behind. Do it again. Good kick. Let's do it to the angle here. Now you can do the same thing with the slap of your foot if you're a really good kicker. Go ahead. He slapped it with his toes. Doesn't hit as hard. Now one more time with your heel. That's how you do it. You have to have real good focus. He would have no problem breaking wood because he's hitting this pretty much in the same center. Hitting pretty much every time in the center. That's a matter of focus. That's what these focus targets are. If you don't have any at home, make sure you get some so somebody can hold it for you while you practice. Okay, that was Dwi Naksechagi. Now he's going to go in into a jump back spin, inside out kick, jump back, jump spin, inside out kick. All right, I'm going to hold the target for that one too. This is just a regular inside outside, back spinning inside outside kick, if you've already done it from one of the other quarters, but bending your knees first and jumping and spinning. A little bit more brain power and a lot more repetitions to get this correct. Nice kick, good, do it again. Good kick. A little harder focus, first time you hit here, second time you hit here. The thing that you have to worry about with this kick, or not worry, but be concerned with, is a lot of people like to do a double bounce. They'll bounce and bounce again, because they want to move in on the target. The whole secret to this thing is going down and getting everything up, everything in spin. Getting that, remembering to get that knee up in the back. Back spinning inside out. Let's try it from the angle now, see if they get a different, slightly different view. So he did a step, double step on that one too, didn't he? He went from here, then jump. Try it again without that step. Just bend your knees and jump. Yeah, very good. Hang time, how long you spend in the air is dependent on how high you get up. Okay, that was Beck's Dwee, or jumping Edon Dwee, also Pakaro Chagi, because it's an inside to outside kick, jumping, spinning. Okay, now we're gonna move on to jump back spin side kick, and jump back spin kick, jump back spin side kick, or just a jump back leg side kick from a Dwee, a back spinning. Okay, I'm gonna stop the bag for me. All right, what you're gonna do, this is just a standard jump spinning side kick. Okay, just from the back side. Nice miss. Straight in. That's right, just a jump. Takes a little bit of athletic ability. Try it again, sir. You bend your knees down, jump, push in, side kick. Okay, that was a jump, backspin side kick. Now we're gonna do a jump back kick. We're not even got into the jump spin, that's for a different quarter. That's a little more, you have to spend a lot of time with that one. That's where you step over the front leg and kick with the front leg. Now he's just gonna do a back kick. Side kick's a little bit easier, that jump spin side kick. Now the jump spin back kick is a little more difficult because you have to stop your rotation and you have to, your back has to be toward the kick. Okay, go ahead. Remember now, when you do these kicks, your back is toward it, your toes and your knees pointed down. That's the hard part. A little harder on a bag because most of the time you want your heel is going to hit first. You want your heel to hit first, but because of the way these bags are, naturally your ball, your foot may hit first too. Go ahead, one more time. Bends down, jumps, and straight back in. Back kick, just like a standard Dwee Chagi this way. But now he's having to jump into it. Okay, that is jump spin back kick, jump spin side kick. Dwee Yap Chagi, or Dwee jump spin back kick. Okay, now we're gonna move on, we're gonna take this down and move on into, thank you, sir. Sorry, to the form, Basai. This is.